TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Lipakshi Khurana. Here are the top stories we're tracking for you on Tuesday, the 26th of November. India celebrates 70th Constitution Day. Pakistan's Supreme Court suspends move to extend Army Chief's tenure. And Sri Lankan president says won't do anything that will harm India's interest. And now for all the details, India on Tuesday celebrated Constitution Day to mark the 70th anniversary of the adoption of the Constitution by the Constituent Assembly on November 26, 1949. The Constitution came into effect on January 26, 1950.
Indian government on Tuesday celebrated Constitution Day or Samvidhan Divas in the Central Hall of Parliament to mark the 70th anniversary of the adoption of the Constitution. The Constitution was adopted by the Constituent Assembly of India on November 26, 1949 and it came into effect on January 26, 1950. President Ramnath Kovind, Vice President M. Venkaya Naidu, Lok Sabha Speaker Om Birla and Prime Minister Narendra Modi addressed the lawmakers on the occasion. In his address to a joint sitting of Parliament to mark the Constitution Day, Prime Minister Narendra Modi said the Indian Constitution stands for the dignity and unity of India and Indians. He saluted Indians for never letting their faith in India's democracy diminish and said that he has always considered India's Constitution to be a holy book.
हमारा संविधान हमारे लिए सबसे बड़ा और पवित्र ग्रंथ है एक ऐसा ग्रंथ जिसमें हमारे जीवन की हमारे समाज की हमारी परंपराओं हमारे मान्यताओं हमारे व्यवहार हमारे आचार उन सब के साथ का समावेश है साथ साथ अनेक चुनौतियों का समाधान भी है
Paying tributes to Bhimrao Ambedkar, the architect of Constitution, Prime Minister Modi said he would be happy to see that India has strengthened and empowered its democracy in the last 70 years. The Prime Minister also recalled the 26/11 Mumbai attacks and paid tributes to those departed on that gruesome day.
News just in, two blast rocked Anantnag and Srinagar districts of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Tuesday, killing at least two people and injuring several. The incident came nearly 3 weeks after a civilian was killed in a grenade attack by terrorists in the region. And moving on, India on Tuesday paid homage to the victims of 26/11 attacks in Western Mumbai city on the 11th anniversary of the assault that further strained ties with Pakistan. At least 166 people were killed in the attack by a terrorist belonging to Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror group.
India remembered the victims of the deadly 26/11 attacks in Western Mumbai city on its 11th anniversary on Tuesday. The terror attacks, which took place in 2008, shook the entire nation. Maharashtra Governor Bhagat Singh Koshyari paid homage to all those who lost their lives in the terror attacks at the police memorial in Mumbai. Several politicians and other dignitaries were also among those who paid their tributes.
जब तक चांद सूरज है तब तक ये घटना कोई नहीं भूल सकता है और संविधान के दिन ही उन्होंने ये हल्ला किया तो हमारे पूरा देश का जो संविधान ऊंचा माना जाता है उसके ऊपर हल्ला है और उसमें इतने लोग शहीद हुए तो थोड़ा दुखदायक आज का दिन है
At least 166 persons, including 6 Americans, were killed in the 2008 Mumbai attacks by 10 gunmen who went on a rampage around various city landmarks for almost 3 days. India blames the gunmen were linked to Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror group. Nevertheless, tensions further soared between the nuclear-armed neighbours, India and Pakistan, after the attacks.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's Supreme Court on Tuesday suspended the notification of Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa's tenure extensions until the hearing on Wednesday. The apex court said that only the President of Pakistan can extend the tenure of the Army Chief.
Pakistan's Supreme Court on Tuesday suspended the notification of extension of Chief of Army Staff General Qamar Javed Bajwa's tenure. A notification from the Office of Prime Minister Imran Khan in August had announced extension of Bajwa's tenure for another term of 3 years. On Tuesday, the court said that only the President of Pakistan can extend the tenure of the Army Chief and noted that out of 25 cabinet members, only 11 had approved the extension. The court issued notices to the Defence Ministry, Federal Government and General Bajwa, who is due to retire on November 29. The hearing was adjourned until Wednesday. During Bajwa's tenure, the military has been accused by opposition politicians of electoral manipulation to bring Prime Minister Imran Khan to power. The military, which has ruled Pakistan for nearly half of its 72-year history, has denied interfering in politics.
The prices of tomatoes have hit a record high in markets in Pakistan. Locals have blamed Prime Minister Imran Khan's government, which was elected on a pledge to eradicate poverty in the country, for rising inflation.
The price of tomatoes in Pakistan has hit a record high amid rising inflation in the country. Retailers in markets of Karachi city are blaming the dwindling supply and rising demand for the increase in prices, while locals are calling out the government for not doing much for the underprivileged people. Residents say the high prices of day-to-day commodities have shattered their faith in the government led by Prime Minister Imran Khan, who was elected last year on a pledge to eradicate poverty in Pakistan. Pakistanis have blamed the Imran Khan government for its ill-timed policies, which are adding to their hardships amid the rising inflation. Various factors have this time led to rising prices of vegetables in the market, including suspension of trade with neighboring India.
Afghanistan's former president, Hamid Karzai, has asked the Afghan government and security forces to defend the freedom of speech and other rights in the country. Karzai also said that there are increasing threats against those who support the US peace talks with the Taliban.
Former Afghan President Hamid Karzai has urged the government and security forces to defend the freedom of speech and other rights in the country. Karzai on Monday asserted that the threats have increased against those who support the US peace talks with the Taliban and called a political analyst the latest victim of it. The former president was one of the Afghan politicians and leaders who took part in Moscow peace talks this year. During the talks, a delegation of Taliban negotiators had met Afghan politicians, including senior regional leaders and candidates who challenged President Ashraf Ghani in this year's presidential election. The meeting was the latest step in efforts to reach a peace settlement. The Taliban since then had talked for months with US diplomats to end the year's long war in Afghanistan. But the peace talks were quashed by the US President Donald Trump after the group claimed responsibility for a bombing in Kabul that killed 12 people, including an American soldier in September.
Sri Lanka's newly elected president, Gotabaya Rajapaksa, is scheduled to visit India on November 29th. Days ahead of the visit, Gotabaya in an interview said his government will not do anything that would threaten India's security.
Sri Lanka's newly elected president, Gotabaya Rajapaksa, has said the country cannot engage in any activity which threatens the security of India and that they understand the importance of Indian concerns. Days ahead of his visit to New Delhi, Gotabaya, in an interview to an Indian website, said he requested the Indian government to help through investments, education and the development of technology. Gotabaya said their involvement with China in the last few years of his older brother Mahinda Rajapaksa government was purely commercial, but geopolitical analysts tried to show it as part of string of pearls which circles India. He said his predecessor government's agreement with China on the southern Hambantota port that has been leased for 99 years was a mistake. Gotabaya said his government will request China to renegotiate and come with a better deal to assist them as people are not happy with the agreement. Gotabaya is scheduled to visit New Delhi on November 29, following an invitation from Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi.
Scientists have successfully performed in vitro fertilization or IVF procedure on 9 buffaloes in India's Pune city. The first of its kind procedure has been taken up to boost dairy farming.
Indian scientists have taken the in vitro fertilization or IVF technology to farmers of the country to make bovine breeding more convenient and affordable. Dr. Shyam Zawar, scientist and in charge at bovine farm JK Bovagenics in Pune city, said 9 pregnancies have been confirmed among buffaloes donated for the research project by the farmers. They will remain with the farmers during the pregnancy and will be brought to the research facility for regular checkups.
We started with embryo transfer in sheep well back in 1975. Then we carried out work on embryo transfer in cattle in 1983. And in 2016, we introduced the technology of IVF in cattle. And very recently, in just last 2 months, we got success in having the IVF pregnancies in buffaloes for the first time in the country.
The process of test tube fertilization, in which eggs are fertilized with sperm outside the body before the embryos are implanted into a female, has been in use since the 1970s to assist in human birth. The process had been performed earlier in laboratory environment, but it is for the first time that such a thing is being experimented on buffaloes on a commercial basis in India.
Timely rainfall this year has given a boost to the quantity and quality of saffron in India's Jammu and Kashmir. In last few years, the production of the spice was dismal because of less rains in the region.
Saffron production and its quality have got a boost due to timely rainfall in India's Jammu and Kashmir this year. Local growers of saffron in the region said the rains have helped them get satisfactory quantity and quality of the spice this year as compared to the previous years. From the last few years, there was a dry spell in the region as lack of irrigation decreased the overall saffron production and affected the income of the growers.
This year, the weather has given us our support. With the weather, we are grateful to God. जिसने इस साल मतलब पिछली तरह अच्छे मौसम पर अपनी बारिश बरसाई जिसकी बदौलत हमारी क्रॉप अच्छे
Among the major horticultural products, saffron is one of the most demanded export products which generates significant employment in rural areas of India's Jammu and Kashmir. District Pulwama, commonly known as a saffron bowl of Kashmir, is dominant in saffron production followed by Budgam, Srinagar and Kishtwar districts.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India celebrates 70th Constitution Day. Pakistan's Supreme Court suspends move to extend Army Chief's tenure. And Sri Lankan President says won't do anything that will harm India's interest. Now our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/SAsianewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.